Hi. There are a couple of key things that we are beginning to see as key initiatives that banks are introducing in the region. And I'll differentiate it between the corporate and the retail side. So on the retail side, with a lot of digital or challenger banks coming into the fray, and we see a lot of the central banks giving out licenses now, Singapore, Thailand, Malaysia, all of them announcing it. The traditional banks are under pressure to begin thinking about how they're going to respond to the challenges of these digital banks. And while some of them, like DBS, UOB, have already done some parts of setting up a digital bank of their own in certain markets, they are now beginning to do that in Singapore and other parts of ASEAN and APAC as well. And that brings in one challenge, because a lot of the banks in the region still run on legacy core banking systems, which make it very difficult for them to innovate at the speed a digital or a challenger bank would. So we are beginning to see banks looking at putting in place a layer which runs across all their legacy systems, but which will enable them to respond to the market in much faster and agile manner than it would permit them with the legacy core bankings that they have. The second trend that we're beginning to see, and this cuts across both the retail and the corporate space, is how do they monetize the open banking, not necessarily regulations, but the open banking trends that are beginning to come in. And that's because of two aspects. One, there is a lot of pressure on the fee that they generate out of traditional banking products, both because of challenger banks and otherwise, where in markets like Thailand, even the central bank is pushing down the transaction pricing. So that is increasingly forcing banks to come up with innovative products and services where they bundle partner products in, and that brings in an ecosystem play with open banking. That's becoming much easier to do, and that's both on the corporate and the retail side. So retail side, I think, is a more obvious play, but on the corporate side, especially in the SME segment, we are beginning to see banks tying up with third-party service providers like payroll or accounting services, etc., and offering a bundle to SMEs. So these are two key trends that we are beginning to see in the APAC region, and which we believe will continue to pick up over the coming 2 to 3 years' time. I think if we look at APAC, it started off a little behind the European region, where the PSD2, etc., was announced, I would say, about 2-3 years ago. Markets like Singapore and Australia did come out with guidelines around open banking some time back, but the rest of the markets, were yet to kickstart. There were some markets like India which didn't wait for regulators to come out with guidelines around them, but believed that was the way to go and started off on their own. But now I think we're beginning to see across markets open banking kind of becoming the trend, with or without regulatory pressures, because banks are beginning to see the value in collaborating with not just fintechs but other ecosystem players. And that's kind of driving it now, more than regulations. And if you look at any of the investor presentations that a lot of the regional banks are doing, whether in the retail or in the corporate space, you will see the ecosystem play being a central part of their strategy over the next 2 to 3 years, because that's where they're beginning to see revenues, potential for revenues increasing. And I think we will continue to see that. There are a lot of players in the open banking space, but a majority of them enable banks from an open banking integration perspective, right? But we are slightly different. We help banks monetize the open banking capabilities that's getting prevalent now. And what that essentially means is, as open banking progresses, as banks continue to tie up and add products and services from their partners, there needs to be a way they can monetize these services. So, for example, we are talking to banks where they are putting together multiple players. For example, let's say in the real estate space, where they're bringing in players from the real estate industry, from insurance, from white goods, etc., and making a one-stop marketplace for individuals to buy property and all the associated services. And what this essentially means is enabling banks to be able to increase the revenues, but also they need to figure out how to share the revenue with each of these ecosystem players. And that's where we come in. So we help them put together this entire ecosystem of players and then figure out how to monetize each of these value-added products or services that they're bringing in for their partners and customers. That's fine. So I think there are a couple of key challenges that banks, especially across ASEAN, are going to be seeing. So one is with the advent of the digital licenses. So if you look at Singapore, the MAS has made it very clear that they are looking at new entities coming into the banking space with the issuance of the digital licenses. And they've also made it very clear on what they expect these digital banks to be addressing as far as the market is concerned. So they have specified that some of them will focus on the retail space, and there are some who will focus, who will be given licenses, and who they expect to focus on the SME space. And if we look at the participants that are applying for these licenses, or at least what we are hearing, we don't know if they formally submitted it, the likes of a Grab, a SingTel, and others, the kind of services that they're going to be able to bring in will cut across not just the banking space, but the whole host of other areas that each of these players operate in. And for the banks, I think that's going to be the challenge. Because to an individual, let's say it's a Grab, for example, that gets a license, along with the banking products that they're going to offer, they're going to be able to give offers and benefits around, let's say, a travel, food delivery, and so on, which a bank at this point in time is not ready to respond to from a product or a service perspective. And putting together that ecosystem, figuring out how to respond in time, in the speed and agility that a digital bank will be able to do it, I think is going to be the key challenge for these banks.